Hello students, today we are going to start with a new chapter that is strategies for the enhancement in food production. So first of all, you can see from NEET point of view, this chapter is not that important because last time and previous years, one or sometimes questions do not come. Yes, but then also you have to remember maybe this time question can come. And the board point of view, questions will come from this chapter. This is a very important chapter. Though it is easy chapter also, you need to concentrate on the idea behind that. But long questions, their possibility is less. But one, two or three mark questions that can come. So first of all, we should know what is that strategies. Actually, what we mean, what we will study in this that chapter, that you know the population of world is now increasing and it is in the verge of exploit, isn't that? So if it is going on exposing the population, then what can happen? Our space, this is not going to increase, this is constant. And due to the population increase, the food product that is available, that is also get shortened time to time. And this way, actually, we start to have less nutrients from the food products. And lots of people, they're suffering from malnutrition or lots of deficiency diseases. So that's why, as we cannot increase the space, okay, so that is limited, that is going to be constant. So in the same area or in the same space, how can we increase the population of the livestock so that we can extract the product to high extent? So we have to increase the qualitative and quantitative value of the food products. For that, we need to adopt different strategies. So in this chapter, we will going to discuss only on those strategies. Okay. So first of all, we should know that as the population is increasing, okay, so that's why, and as population is increasing and our area is limited, so that's why what we have to do, we have to adopt some strategies. Okay, so what are those strategies we need to adopt to increase the, and what is the main idea of this chapter, why we need to know this? Because due to increased population, increase in the population, we need to adopt the techniques, and those conventional technique till our society and our country is adopting, that is not sufficient. So that's why we need to include some advanced technologies, advanced techniques, and all those techniques we are going to start now. So just see, as the population is increasing and area is constant or limited, we need to adopt some strategies. Why? Because we need to increase the qualitative and quantitative value of the food products. Okay, then only we can able to have this population. Okay, as the population is increasing, so that's why we have to adopt the strategies to increase the quantitative and qualitative value of the food products. Very important thing, that those problems are actually directly associated with the that is animal husbandry and plant breeding. So in this chapter, we will see all those things. See, first of all, what is animal husbandry? Okay, so what is the meaning of animal husbandry? Animal husbandry means it is actually breeding and raising the livestock. Okay, So what is breeding technique? Breeding technique means it is the controlled mating. Okay, controlled mating is known as breeding. Normally in nature, what happened, the male and the female organism reproduce, they mate and they undergo fertilization, that means the gamete undergo fertilization and it produces the zygote. Zygote complete the embryonic development in the mother's womb and after that it give birth the new young ones. So this is the normal natural process. But if suppose the population, suppose different other organisms, other animals, livestock basically, suppose cattle or buffalo, they go for the normal mating process, then it is not possible that it can feed the high population. So that's why what happened, we need to breed the animals. We need to control mating. That means we are going to decide which male will mate with which female. So that one, that procedure of control mating process, that is known as breeding process. Breeding and raising the livestock. Okay, so how we can able to raise the population? We can able to raise the population, we have to feed good quality food. Okay, next thing, good quality food. So this is the most important thing we need to adopt so that this breeding technology can yield high value. Okay, second thing, we need to maintain cleanliness. Okay, cleanliness for the house where they are kept as well as their own health. That means so that these animals have to be butted at a regular interval so that they do not suffer from any kind of disease. And the third thing also we need to know that the housing should be also a very important thing. Okay, suppose for human, our primitive need is what? We need food, we need clothes and we need house. But for the livestock, it is only the food and the house, isn't that? So if we provide good housing quality and the food quality, then obviously their raising, that means their yielding will be very much high. Okay, so to raise any type of livestock, we need to provide them food, we need to maintain their cleanliness, their house as well as their health, and along with that the housing should be properly maintained. I will tell you what should be the characteristics of a proper house for a farm. Then after that we need to know that what are those livestock. So livestock include all the domesticated animals. Okay, see, whenever we talk about the strategies for the enhancement in food production, we are not going to breed or raise the wild animals from where we will not able to extract anything, right? Suppose if it is the suppose lion or tiger, then this is not going to give us anything in return. So that will not come under animal husbandry, that will be different part, that will be wildlife. But for the domesticated animal, what we have, the animal husbandry. So under the livestock, how many animals will come? We will have cow or cattle, same thing, then buffalo, right, then goat or sheep, then the pig, right. Next one, we can also have poultry, that means the birds, right. Next one, we will have fishery also, that means the cultivation culture of the fishes, different kinds of varieties of fishes. And then we will also have honeybee, right? So these are coming under the livestock from where it can give us some products which we are going to get as food, right? So that will come under the livestock. And for proper raising of livestock, some other animals are also required. So they are some other animals. Okay, So what are those other animals who can properly take care of the livestock? Their dogs, right? Why? The dogs for the security. Okay, that means suppose a farmer, they have suppose one herd of cow or sheep or goat. So those dogs will take care of that herd. They will take them to a area, feed for the whole day, and bringing back to the owner's house. Once again, that will be the function of the dogs, and that obviously have to be trained. Second thing, next animal that can be cats also. So these cats that can kill some type of birds, they can kill some type of predators or some another animals, they can harm the livestock. Okay, maybe suppose for rabbits, there's a for the rabbits some type of predators are there, some type of other animals which can kill the rabbit. The cats are going to eat it, so they are going to kill the other animals of rodents. Okay, so for that, what we need to have some other type of animals also. Now, how many type of products we can get from the livestock, right? So first of all, we basically take care of the animals, livestock, for three reasons. What are the reasons? See, why we are going, or what type of things extract we can able to extract from the livestock. First thing, this is food, right? Second thing, we can get the clothing also. Okay, next one, we can also take for pulling or to carry. Okay, so for these three reasons, we are going to take care of the animals. So just see how many type of food products we can extract from the livestock. So from the cow, buffalo, goat, or from the sheep, we can able to get the milk, we can get meat, we can get egg, right? So this type of things we can extract, as well as honey, isn't that? So this type of food products we can extract from the livestock. Next thing, for clothing, we can get the silk, isn't that? Silk, then wool, they can be extracted from the different type of animals, like sheep, like from the other animals, like from sheep and goat. Basically, we can able to extract the different varieties of silk and wool, right? Next one, for pulling and carrying, we can also take care of some other type of animals for the purpose of transport of the things. Earlier than nowadays, it is the machines or the engines or the cars, they actually transport the thing. But from the earlier time, it was the animals who actually help for the transportation and help human. What are they? They are horse or donkey. They actually were used for the purpose of pulling or carrying. So they are the reasons actually why we actually have to breed or raise the livestock, for these three reasons, right? To get, to extract food, to extract the wool or the silk, and for the carrying purpose or for the transportation purpose also, we can raise the livestock. Now, after that, let us move to the next part. After that, see, it is estimated, if we go for some statistical analysis, then we will get to know that around 70%, okay, around 70% of the livestock are only found in India, okay, in India and China. okay? That means population wise, if you see the population of the livestock is very high in India and the China. But what happened? From those population, we will extract the products, right? So those products, if you see, then the product to the world farm, this is only 25%. That means if we have that much population, then why we are able to extract only 25% of the products? There must be some problems, there must be some lack of knowledge or lack of some strategies, because of what we can actually still lack the productivity. So the productivity is very less. That means the product per capita is very less. Okay, so actually from that population, from 70% of population, we can extract at least 70% of the products, food products, but it is not happening. It is even 25%, isn't there? That means the product per capita is very less. So why this is happening? This is happening because in the process, how actually we are raising the different animals, livestock, there must be some problems. So till in India, we are not going to talk about the other countries. So if we talk about India, in very few areas, actually some modern technologies are adopted. But till now in India, maximum population, human, actually go for some conventional techniques. See, in India, how actually we are raising the animals, there are two techniques we have. One is the conventional technique. Okay, one is the conventional technique and second one is the scientific, okay, scientific technique. Okay, so in the conventional technique, we don't have to take care of anything. We just going to provide the house. We are not giving proper care of those animals. So that's why in the conventional technique, the productivity is very less. Okay, productivity is very less because the proper knowledge to the farmers are till not given. So that's why they lack the those knowledge by which they can increase the product. It is still not known to the farmer. So that's why the productivity is very less. But in the scientific technologies, the product can be increased. The productivity can be increased. How the productivity can be increased? By some proper management. Okay, we need to have some management, then only it is possible that we can increase the product. So what are all those management? See, for the management, we will scientifically study the different breeds. We need to breed the animals by controlled mating technologies. Different varieties of technologies are available so that the suppose a cow or buffalo, they can give high amount of the products. Normally our cow suppose produce 2 liters or 3 liters of milk suppose, right? Now adopting those scientific strategies, scientific technologies, the productivity from 2 liters, it can increase to suppose 20 liters. Okay, so all those strategies we are going to see now. So first of all, let us start with the dairy farm management, right? So let us start. So just see, in this dairy farm management, how many things we can get from the milk. Okay, so first of all, how many animals are taken for the dairy farm management? From the animals from where we can extract milk, okay, we can get milk, they are cow, buffalo, goat and sheep in general. but yes, from the camel and from yak also, in various places the milk is extracted. Okay, but in general we can have this cow, buffalo, goat and sheep. Next one, see how many type of products we can get. Okay, suppose you have milk, right? So this milk, if you rotate, if you churn, okay, if you churn, then what we can get, that above we can get the condensed fat. So that will be the cream. Okay, so the binet part, that will have the liquid part that can further add, suppose a little curd, then it will be converted into curd. If you coagulate it, okay, if you clot it, okay, by using this casein, some drops of casein, then it can convert into cheese, right? Next one, if you take this milk, okay, and if you boil it, okay, then we can get ghee above, okay, we can get ghee, then the remaining product that will be known as the buttermilk, okay. Now next one, this buttermilk can be further processed, and after that we can get lassi, isn't it? So the various varieties of products we can get from milk, okay, varieties of products are there, we can extract. It is numbers of, if we start counting, then a numbers of products we have to see. So how many types of products in general we can get? Yeah, so what are they? Cream, curd, ghee, buttermilk, cheese. From where we can able to produce ice cream, then various types of candy bar from the milk, okay, like Milky Bar. Then after that we can able to have different type of cheese, okay, varieties of cheese are available. Then yes, we can get the butter, isn't that? So varieties of products are there, right? So if we can able to get this much of product, okay, just by take care of this animals, then in huge production, in mass scale, how we can able to get the high product value, right? So let us see what are the systems to be adopted to increase the yield. Okay, so first of all, we have to go for a better breed. Okay, we have to select the breed, and selection of the breed is the most important thing. So whenever we go for the selection, suppose there is a farmer, suppose me, from now I am thinking of having a animal farm, suppose. Then first of all I have to choose one animal, and that breed, that animal breed, how many qualities I will check. Okay, first thing what we need to know, that need to have high yielding quality. Okay, so from that animal I need to have high yielding. If suppose there is a cow who can give only 2 liters or 3 liters of milk in a day, then that animal I'm not going to take in my farm, at least, isn't that? So first of all we have to check the high, that means the productivity. If it is the high yielding or their productivity is high, then only we can go for the selection. Second characteristics in that breed, that it should be resistant to disease. Okay, so it should be resistant to disease. So normally this animal in a simple disease they shouldn't die, right? And it should be easy to maintain, easy to take care of, easily available, they can adapt to the changing environment. All those qualities we will check in a breed. So if it is a dairy farm management, dairy mint means that milk producing animals, right? So for the milk producing animals, how many animals we basically think that yes, from here we can able to extract more milk, isn't that, or good quality milk. So here we have two animals, one is cow, another is buffalo, right? So cow, generic name is Boss, okay, and buffalo, it is Bubalus. Okay, Bubalus is the scientific name of buffalo, and Boss is the generic name, and Bubalus is also the generic name of cow and buffalo. And if it is cow, indigenous cow, then yes, it is Boss indicus, and generic name of buffalo is Bobulus, specific name is also Bobulus. So just see if it is the cow and buffalo. Okay, if you need to just compare cow and buffalo, then we need to know that from these two animals, which one will be a better option for dairy farm management. See, buffalo will be a better one. Why buffalo is better animal than or over cow? Because cow is very much prone to disease. In a simple disease, suppose there is a problem in the ear and they can die. Okay, in a simple bacterial disease or simple, suppose a normal fever, it can die. But buffalo, as compared to cow, is now a little bit more resistant to the disease. Generally, they don't die. Okay, next thing, in case of cow, the milk will have less quality as if you compare. See, cow also have good quality milk, okay, but if you compare with buffalo milk will have more fat content as compared to the cow. Okay, so yes, in dairy farm management we can take both these two animals. They are very much common, but apart from that, sheep, goat are also can be used for the milk also. But yes, goat and sheep have some other value also. What are they? For clothing, isn't that? That means from the fur of goat and sheep, we can able to extract the carpet wool. We can able to get the normal wool for the shawl. Pashmina even is extracted from one variety of sheep, isn't that? So they have dual purpose. But for milk, purely only milk, then it will be cow and buffalo, right? So let us see some breeds of cow and buffalo both. Okay, it's not that important, but yes, for boards it may be important, sometime it can come. So let us see that there's no more. Okay, so first of all, for cow, see, there are two varieties we have. One is Indian, indigenous, local, and another is foreign, right? So if it is indigenous cow, then we have Gir, then Red Sindhi, a very famous indigenous cow, and Shahiwal. This cow, these varieties of cow, they are now adopted to Indian climate. So in Indian climatic condition, they can survive better. If you see some foreign breeds of cow, then we can get Jersey, then Brown Swiss, then Holstein Friesian. They are some foreign breeds of cow. But yes, this cow, they are not resistant to the climatic condition, or they cannot survive in extreme heat, right? So that's why what happened. Yes, they cannot survive in India, and in India this animal, this cow animal, this cow breeds can survive, but their productivity is less. But yes, Jersey production is production of milk from Jersey or Brown Swiss is very high. So what we have to do, cross this two, okay, like suppose Brown Swiss and Shahiwal, Red Sindhi and Holstein Friesian, then yes, that animal can survive in Indian climatic condition, as well as their productivity will be also very high, right? So that's why we need to know those breeds of animals, right? So these are the cow breeds, okay? These are very much common. Red Sindhi, Shahiwal, you have to remember. And for brown, that for foreign breeds, Brown Swiss and Holstein Friesian, they are also very much important. Now let us move to some buffalo breeds. Okay, Mura, then Mehsana, Shuti, then Zafrawali. They are also some breeds of buffalo, and yes, all of them, they are indigenous. Their productivity is high also, as well as their nutrient quality as compared to cow is also high. They're resistant to disease as compared to cow. So buffalo is a better option. What is the scientific name of buffalo? It is Bobulus bovalus. And if it is cow, then it is Bos indicus if it is the Indian cow, right? So the next portion, we need to know about the dairy farm management, that is the housing. Okay, so in what type of house we need to keep that animals, right? So that house should be pro- Okay, so they have to be cleaned. Next one, they need to have proper aeration technique. That means properly so that the air can come. Okay, so open air can come, enter and take suppose, or that oxygen level have to be high, normal. Next one, they need to be properly, the flooring should be maintained. Next one, they need to have proper water supply. Okay, so those things have to be needed. They have to be present in a house of a dairy farm or any suppose cow or buffalo. They need to have those house where proper aeration, proper water supply, proper sunlight have to come to their house. Okay, then it should be properly cleaned, right? So those things have to be there in the houses. So those characteristics are must. Next one, cleanliness for both the house as well as for the cow or the buffalo, properly they have to be bathed. Okay, so these things are important. Next one, regular visit to the vet. Yes, see, this is also very much important. Whenever we have a suppose farm of having 20 cow or 30 cow, or suppose in large scale hundreds of buffalo are there in the farm. So which one is giving what suppose product, how much liters of milk they're giving, how much amount of food products is given, or what quality of food product is given. So those things have to be regularly checked, right? They have to be properly immunized. They have to properly, regularly checked up by the veterinary doctors. Then only it is possible that if they are suffering from any disease or suppose some deficiency diseases, then what will happen? The product, the yield will also have less quality, or nutritional value of the milk will have less. Isn't it? Less nutritional value. So that's why their health should be properly checked up. Okay, proper feedback have to be taken. Then only one can understand that this type of problems are there. So according to that problem, they can properly take care of. So proper visit regulation are must. Okay, visit to the doctors regularly at one interval, they have to be checked up. Proper immunization so that they do not suffer from any bacterial disease or viral diseases, or pox, all those pox and suppose some diseases are like Ranikhet. These diseases are at one period of time in 1950s, it was like pandemic, and crores of cow and buffalo, they died actually. And then mass immunization was provided by government, and that way actually the cow and the buffalo herd was somehow conserved. Okay, so proper visit to the doctors, proper immunization is must. Next thing, see, the feed is must, because the first thing one cow or buffalo need is the feed. Okay, then the house, then after that they will give you the product. So what are the feed? So the under the feed we need to provide two things. One is roughage and another is concentrate. Okay, now what is roughage? Roughage means which have the proper or high fiber content. Okay, so what we can give to the animals, cow or buffalo or goat or sheep, their hay. We can take hay or straw. Okay, so these are good for the animals that have high fiber content. Okay, so this is the main thing. Along with that, they also need to be given concentrates. What are the concentrates? They are cereals. Next one, millets that have to be given. Next one, some oil cakes. Okay, next one, some leaf of various plants. Okay, so that have to be given, that has high vitamin and mineral content, that can be provided to the cow or the buffalo, which can enrich the food quality, and that also will increase in the productivity. So the nutritional value will be very much high. Okay, one thing we need to know about the cleanliness. Okay, so first thing that whenever we have these breeds, the animals should be at regular interval, they have to be butted. Second point that whenever it comes to their house, we need to properly, regularly clean the house. Otherwise, those cow and buffalo can suffer from disease. Next, cleanliness we have to maintain whenever we will extract the milk. So whenever someone will milking, isn't that? So then they one have to properly take the measurements. Okay, so properly nowadays with the machines actually they take the milk out. Okay, and also during the transportation of the milk in the large vessels by which actually the milk is transporting from one to the next for packaging, in that time period also for the transportation also during the transportation they have to be cleaned. Okay, and the last one, that is packaging. During packaging also proper hygiene, cleanliness need to be maintained. But yes, nowadays lots of advanced technologies have arose, like the pasteurization of the milk, we know. Second thing, nowadays hexapack, then tetrapack, they're available in Amul Taza packet, you know that, na? There are silver foil, silver packet, then there is another transparent, then that is paper. There are hexapack or tetrapack are available. So nowadays they're not much problem related to cleanliness because with the help of machines only it is extracted. But whenever it comes to cleanliness, it have to be a multi-step process. First of all, to the cow and buffalo, their health should be properly maintained. If they are not properly clean, then their products will also not at all be cleaned, isn't there? So during the product, during milking, during transportation and during package, we need to maintain the proper cleanliness. Okay, so all these points we need to take care of whenever it came to dairy farm management. So these things only you have to know, right? So what are the first point is breed. Second point is housing. Third one is feed, roughage and concentrates. Roughage means it will have high fiber content. Okay. And concentrate, that will have high mineral content. Okay. So this two. Next one in cleanliness. Okay. And the fifth one, that is regular visit to the vet. Okay, so these things have to be maintained for the dairy farm management. Okay, after that, whenever we're talking, let's just see some diseases, but those diseases are not to be remembered. Yes, but yes, let's just see them. Okay, we are not going to leave anything, so just see some diseases. What are they? We'll see only two diseases. One is viral. Okay, and another is bacterial. Okay, so what is that viral disease? See, one very important, I just have given the example, that viral disease is cow plague. Okay, cow plague or Rinderpest.
Okay. Rinderpest.
That was one very dangerous disease, viral disease, who around crores of cow did died in India, across India. Then after that, mass immunization happened in around 1950. Okay, so this is one viral disease. And what is that bacterial disease? That is anthrax. Okay, so these two are the diseases only, the causative organism. They are bacillus if it is coming to the bacterial disease. Okay, so these are all about the dairy farm management. We need to know these points, you have to remember. Okay, this is very easy, just remember 2-3 points and you will get full 2-3 marks. Okay, so that is all about the dairy farm management. In the next video we will see the poultry farm management and other managements. So that's all about the video. Thank you.